because
what else are you meant to do with a Floyd Rose guitar, man, right? Hi everyone, Keiran from Guitar Guitar here, and I am very excited to be joined by Martin from ENGL in our studio today. Thank you so much for popping down, man. I'm really happy to have you here. And I'm also very excited today because Martin has brought an amp that I've been very excited to get my hands on as well, which we'll obviously get into a little bit later. But how are you doing anyway, man? Are you okay?
I'm pretty good, yeah. Awesome. Thank you for having me here.
Thank you for popping down, obviously, as well. But before we get into, obviously, the amp that we've got in the studio today, I just want to get a little bit just, you know, of sort of celebration, I guess, because you guys are 40 years old.
Yeah,
today.
So ENGL has its, the company is 40 years old right now, so... it's a great thing for us.
Yeah. Absolutely incredible, yeah. Because for years and years, first of all, I didn't know that it was 40 years old as well myself. Certainly since I was a teenager, I've seen ENGL on kind of hard rock and metal stages all across the world and some huge bands and everything. And I've always been, you know, not unaware of what the kind of bigger models are, but, you know, what would you say are, you know, some of the kind of main highlights when it comes to the ENGL sort of catalog?
So I would say the our core series is the ball series, so the Fireball, Powerball, Ironball.
Yep.
Yeah. So then we have the Savage.
I've heard that quite quite a few sort of big artists are right into the Savage, aren't they?
Yeah, sure. But the main series is the ball series, with the smallest one is the Ironball, and this is the Ironball Special Edition. Two channel amp, each channel is boostable, digital effects section, power soak, IR loader.
Kind of ticks all the boxes, really, of any, like, for modern players and certainly for kind of, you know, some maybe old school players as well. It's kind of got everything that we would need, just, you know, in a much smaller channel. Because certainly for my sort of experience with ENGL, once I got familiar with them, I've always known about, you know, massive 100 watt heads that can, you know, blow the face off of everybody in the front row. But certainly having something 20 watts, you know, shrunken down with a power soak, with an IR loader and stuff, it's kind of something that a lot of guitarists want these days.
Yeah, so it's easier to carry, and you can have a fly show, so you can carry it with your hand luggage, easy recording in your home studio.
Absolutely. So, and the fact that obviously this has got the digital effects in it as well, kind of, as you said, means it could be a fly rig and you wouldn't need your pedal board and you wouldn't need as much to go into that. So yeah, super, super cool. I mean, I've only had maybe about kind of 5-10 minutes before we really got into the recording today to have a play about, and I was immediately impressed because of just those big chunky tones we heard at the start there. Yeah, why don't we kind of dive right into the Powerball. This is the Ironball Special Edition 20 here. So let's take a look at this amp, kind of see what it is. I'm very willing just to let you take the reins on this, man, and kind of explain what went into this and everything.
Yeah, so we can start with the clean channel and maybe add some reverb to it.
Let's do it, yeah. Let's just hear that immediately there. That's really, really nice clean on that. And it's one of those things, certainly in my experience, obviously, of playing with higher gain amps, is obviously the focus is so much on that real chunky, in-your-face distortion that sometimes the clean channel can kind of be forgotten about a little bit, you know, just kind of maybe with classic amps and everything. I mean, that's sparkly, it's, you know, loads of headroom in it, and especially with those effects as well, it sounds absolutely incredible. You mentioned that there's boosts on each channel so
we can boost it with the...
Thank you. that's almost kind of a crunch channel.
Yeah.
And with that as well there.
Breaks up somewhere at around noon.
Yeah.
So depending on the pickups.
On the kind of guitar as well. I mean, even just for talking sake as well. So this this very lovely E2 that I'm playing for this today, this is a Horizon 3. This has got a coil split on it, so let's see how it just handles very quickly with some single coil tones. Totally got that like spanky sort of like what you would expect with a single coil as well. So yeah, that sounds absolutely superb. And we just had the reverb on for that channel as well there, didn't we? Yeah. Is that kind of like based on just like a hall reverb, or is it like something plate-wise?
It's based on a hall reverb. So
nice. I can get
tweaked it as so. We did a lot of time for tweaking the effects.
Nice.
So.
And obviously, like, that can go from quite subtle to absolutely massive as well. I think it's important, obviously, just before we jump over to, you know, some of the other effects or the lead channel as well, that you can control these all via MIDI. Yeah. And obviously foot switchable as well, which is a huge thing.
But it's necessary, to be honest, if you want to have everything. So without MIDI, it makes sense to play the amp, but with MIDI it's the whole package. So
absolutely. And it allows you to obviously just freely form through all the switches, because certainly you're going to be wanting to focus on riffing rather than switching switches while we're playing live. Just before we jump over as well, can I hear a bit of the delay channel on here as well? Almost with like two channels and the ability to, you know, kind of crunch up that clean channel a little bit as well. It's, and you know, with the effects and everything, it's kind of an entire rig in a box, really, isn't it? Sounds absolutely incredible. Cool. Shall we jump onto the
some
high
stuff?
High gain. let's go.
Yeah. So this is the highest gain setting. So.
There's that tone I've heard for years and years, that nice chunky sort of, you know, you can really feel that in the room, which is super important.
And it's completely silent with the noise gate, so.
I mean, we're playing pretty high gain right now as well. And, you know, the pickups in here as well are quite high output, which is cool as well.
So we can adjust it on the backside.
It's So any modern player who needs that really, really tight attack, I'm sure everybody heard that, like, absolutely suffocating that note when he turned it up high. But, you know, for certain situations, that's absolutely perfect, you know. And obviously, you had the game boost on there as well, which, yeah, as I said, just the feeling of this amp in the room here is kind of one of the most important things, because it's just, you can really feel the kind of chunkiness, as I've mentioned, and that's, I may be getting giddy right now, but I just love playing with, you know, really high gain amps like this. So we flipped the amp around because actually I think there's a lot of really important features that we should touch on with here. Certainly, I don't think I've seen an amp with this many, you know, notable features on the back of it as well, which you're getting, you know, kind of double the fun on the front and the back there. So obviously the controls for the noise gate and the reverb and the delay, we've kind of been over. All the options to change are just on the back there. We've got the power soak option there as well, so you can play in your house without annoying your neighbors. But one of the most important things that I want you to kind of talk through with me just now is the, obviously, the direct out and the IR selection that is in here, because there is a few already loaded into this amp, isn't there?
Yeah, so we have three built in. It's a 2x12, a 4x12, and our XXL.
Awesome.
Equipped with vintage 30s. But you can load your own or your favorite third-party IRs into this thing. So we have five slots.
Awesome. That makes it really customizable for anybody as well, if they have, obviously, their favorite one that they want to use.
You can switch between preamp or power amp, so that you have the saturation from the power tubes with your balance direct out, just like you want it.
Absolutely, exactly like you want it, so with, obviously, the IRs that are loaded into here, we're gonna play through a couple and we'll just see exactly how they can really, really sort of change your sound. Because I think that's a really important thing, is certainly with guitarists these days, they are discovering the importance of your cab, you know, and what kind of speakers and what kind of size you're using can really shape your tone. All the sounds you will be hearing are coming directly out of the balanced output there, all direct, and of course you can turn the speaker completely off if you want to do a silent recording as well, which is really, really cool. So yeah, we're going to be starting with the 2x12, I think I'm right in saying that, number one.
Yeah.
And I'll let Martin just kind of cycle through them as I just play some riffs on this just now. So obviously, what we were hearing in the room there was just all from the matching 1x12 there. So obviously, you guys will hear the difference in the sounds of that. We were kind of just briefly discussing it beforehand as well, as the fact you've obviously have an additional, you know, few slots for own IRs in there. I think, again, that's just something that's really important for any guitarist who wants to make it, you know, totally theirs. You know, you can have your favorite speaker, you'll have your favorite, obviously, responses and whatnot. Yeah. And it's just a really cool, obviously, feature to throw into there. And the fact that there's already some preloaded as well, it's just allowed people to just immediately jump in. And let's face it, ENGL cabs are amazing anyway. Yeah. So, Vex loop there, there's obviously the USB. We have the straight off foot switch, but as we mentioned as well, there's the MIDI input for, you know, getting the most out of this amp as well.
So it's our recommendation to use it with our C9 MIDI foot switch. It can be powered with phantom power, so you don't need a separate supply.
Awesome.
Unit. Yeah.
Yeah, that's really, really cool, man. So one of the things, Martin, we always like to kind of touch in our videos, first of all, obviously, thank you so much for joining us and sort of explaining what is going into the Special Edition Iron Ball. But one thing that we always kind of like to touch on is, you know, who is this amp for? Who would get the most out of it? And certainly you were giving us a little bit of an explanation of why ENGL built this, you know, with the sort of mission statement in mind. So what would that be in your guys' eyes?
So we built this unit for the passionate music musician, music lover, to have it, to have all in one thing, easy to carry for the home studio, for stages, big or small. You can almost do everything with this little guy. So
you really can, and that's been one of the things that I've definitely noticed myself is just using this. It's just I will find when I plug into other sort of high gain metal focused amps that immediately I just start, you know, gallop picking and I start doing tremolo picking and I just play all those old Metallica riffs that I grew up playing. But I was finding with some other sections of this amp that it moved me into a different sort of, you know, headspace. And certainly with having all in one, it just allows you to be a lot more expressive with your playing and a lot more kind of basis covered. And you just know sort of security wise that you're like, oh, well, I'm covered if I need, you know, reverb, I'm covered if I need delay. I need a nice clean channel for like my country gig, but then I need a metal channel as well for the gig later down the line. And certainly the more kind of smaller amps that are coming out these days that still pack the punch, you know, it saves all our backs when we're going to gigs and everything. But yeah, I definitely would agree with you on that sense that, you know, just a passionate musician, I think, will get a lot out of this. And certainly home studio, on stage, even just, you know, you can turn up to a gig just with a guitar, your amp heads, and if they've got a cab there, that's great, but you can also just go directly into a front of house as well. So I think it's really, really, really cool just what you're getting with it, but I think a lot of people will get so much out of this as well. But yeah.
You have so many possibilities with...
Just within the one box. And, and I mean, you said to me as well that the back of this amp looks like a spaceship, like, which is, I think it really does. And that allows for, you know, creative expression as well, and just allows you to kind of be really excited about the amp. I think it's good. You're going to have a hard time getting this back off of me by, at the end of the day, because I might just have to hold on to it. So, what do you think in the comments? Let us know down below. Obviously, are you a fan of ENGL? Have you tried any of the new Ironball Special Editions as well? Because I think you really, really owe it to yourself to try it out. But as always, I've been Keiran from Guitar Guitar. And again, big, huge thanks to Martin from ENGL for joining us today. Have a great day.